Hello everyone. So today we'll be looking into the questions which appear in part A of UCED and CED. So we are going to see certain questions and we'll see how easy they become once you try to find out how visually they are being represented. So let us look at this one question. This question you might have seen in the previous year questions already. See, when they are talking about the parameter, we know that these are really easy. These are the straight sides which are given as 10. And then these are also very straightforward. These are 5. But the real question comes, what about this and this? Suppose if I put a line here and similarly a line here. So can you see now that these are the folded surfaces? From this point, they might have been folded towards this side. If we open this up to this side and this to this side, then this will completely become like this after being folded. If I try to put it here, if I fold it back, it will become like this. So that means these small portions that we are talking about, these are only this portion which are remaining portions of this side. So now if we see this, it becomes really easy. This side plus this side plus this side, then this complete side, and then these two which are easily given to us as 5. So it would be 10 plus 10 plus 10, then the top 10, and then 5 of these two. So that means 5 plus 5. So that becomes 50. So let us go along with the next question. Now this question also you must have seen. Now in this question, first of all, we have to see that all these sides, they are given equal, and also they have put SQ here. That means this side is also equal. Now with this, what we have to see is the black portion. Now see, they have taken some portion out. If we complete this circle, then this is the extra portion that they want to talk about. Either you have to put in many circle theorems and other theorems to find it out, or what you can try to see is that this portion is left vacant. So 90%, 99% of the times, in fact, the portion that is outside of the circle and which is left vacant would be same. So when you see this, then this portion is equal to this portion. So if we cut this portion and put it inside it, it will be a complete circle or not. That means what you have to find out eventually is the area of this circle. And now for finding out area of any circle, the most important part that we need to have is radius. So what is given to us in this portion? If we see this, only this length is given. Let us put all our effort into finding this radius, because we know once we find the radius, we can find out the area of this circle. Let us look into this figure now. When we draw this, the given portion, so this is the given line, right? So if we take this as the center of this circle and this as the center of this circle, and they have already told us that this is also equal to the other lines. So let us join these as well. So that means if we talk about it, this is the radius, and these both circles are equal. So this is the radius and this is the radius of this circle. This is the portion which we don't know about, because this complete portion is 21. So this is what we have to calculate. See, this side is equal to this side and is equals to this SQ. So this is an equilateral triangle. So let us try to solve it with the basic knowledge we have. Now see, this side is the radius only of this circle, and this side is the radius of this circle, and the both circles are equal. So these two sides are equal. That means these two angles are equal only. I am putting X here. And if we can see in this triangle, in triangle PQS, it is an equilateral triangle. So every angle is 60. That means this complete angle is 60. And because this is coming in between, so this would be 30. Similarly, this would be 30. This complete angle is 60. And these two angles, X and X, are also equal according to what we have just seen. So they would also be 60. Now, when we have seen that all three angles of this triangle is also 60, that means this side and this side and this is also equal. Now when this is also equal, that means it is also equal to radius, because these are radius only. Now PR is given as 21 and it is divided into three portions. One portion is this, second portion is this base, and third portion is this. And all three are now equal. So that means radius would be 21 by 3, that is 7. And when we know the radius, we can know the area of the circle. It would be pi r square. So 22 by 7, then into 7 into 7. So it would be 154. I hope this is clear. Now let us move to the next question. Now this question also you must have seen in the previous year questions. And again, we'll try to solve it with minimum maths. Okay. And not the typical theorems. So when we look at this question, it is saying that the perimeter of this triangle, which is an equilateral triangle, is equal to this regular hexagon. So if I take one side of this triangle as 4a, so the whole perimeter of this triangle would be 12a. And now this same perimeter is there for this regular hexagon and it has six sides. So it will be 2a. One side will be 2a. Now let us try to find out the radius of this smaller circle. So this is the radius and this side would be half, that is 2a. Now this angle would be half of this complete angle, and complete angle is 60 because it is a equilateral triangle. So this would be 30. So we can put the theorem as 10 30. What is the perpendicular? R here, and base is 2a. So here we will write it as 1 by root 3 R upon 2a. So here we can find out R is equals to 2a by root 3. Similarly, here also we can drop this height. So here, because the side is 2a, half would be only a, and this angle would be half of the complete angle. And what are the angles of our hexagon? It is 120 degree. So this will be 60 degree. That is half of that. So if we put 10 60 here, let it be capital R because it is a bigger circle, the radius of R, R divided by A, and 1060 is root 3. So R is equals to root 3 by A. Now if we can see the ratio of R divided by R, it would be root 3A divided by 2A, and root 3 would come up. So it would be 3 by 2. Now as the radius ratio is 3 by 2, so what would be the circumference of the bigger circle? It would be 3 by 2 of the smaller circle, that is 10. So it would be 15 centimeter. But let us also look into this question from one another point of view. And that would be, if we take this hexagon and if we increase these lengths like this. Now if we see this triangle, this complete angle is 120 degree of regular hexagon. So this would be 60 degrees. Similarly, if we see this 120 degrees, so this would be 60, and hence this would also be 60. And in same similar case, both these triangles are also equilateral with the same side equal to the side of a hexagon. If we take the complete side of this triangle as 2a, then this would be a, the hexagon side only up to this point. And this would also be a because it is an equilateral triangle now we have seen. And this would also be a. So that means, if the side of this triangle is 2a, then side of this bigger triangle is 3a. If we see the ratio, then the side of the bigger triangle is equals to 3 by 2 the side of a smaller triangle. So in the same way, now as the circle inscribed in a smaller triangle is 10, the circle inscribed in bigger triangle would be 3 by 2 of 10, that is 15, as the lengths of the triangle we have already compared. So this is how you have to put the visual perspectives into consideration. And in all such scenarios, you have to think about the fact that the remaining portions would mostly be equal, as we saw in that circle. So I hope you like the video. Be with us and we'll come up with more such videos. Thank you and have a nice day.